Then we find these two words, asfim, faja'alahum, then he made them, he transformed them. Ja'ala in Arabic is used when you have something and you turn it into something else. Like you can take wood and turn it into a table, ja'ala. Not khalaqa. Khalaqa means you created it out of nothing. But ja'ala, you took something and you made it something else. Okay? So for example, in Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا. He took you, he made you into a nation, a balanced nation. So you're already there, but he transformed you. So Allah is saying, these people, Allah transformed them. So that, and by the way, when ja'ala is used, someone was something else before and there's something else after. So they were a powerful army before. And now when Allah transformed them, what did they become? Now we'll find out. فَجَعَلَهُمْ. He didn't say, فَجَعَلَهُمْ عَصْفٌ مَأْكُولٌ. He said, كَعَصْفٍ مَأْكُولٌ. كَ is used for tashbih. It's used to give likeness. He made them like. He made them like. So Allah wants us to compare what they look like to something you can see. This is also important. We're not there. We're not in front of these armies. We didn't see what happened. It's not on video. So Allah is presenting us video by means of His words. He's presenting us the imagery by means of His words. You want to know what they look like? Because I asked you to wonder, how did I deal with them? You want to know how they look like? Let me tell you, they looked like ka, and then asf in ma'kul. So let's look at both of these words one at a time. Asf in Arabic, and asif especially, is used for winds. Winds that blow, you know, cut off leaves that are, you know, these crumpled up leaves, especially in the fall, they're all over the ground. And when wind is blowing, you see them in the air. That kind of wind is called asifa. الريح عاصف. عاصف, literally that which is blowing the leaves and the pebbles in the air. عصف is the, عصفة actually, is the leaf of a tree that has been cut off and withered and broken up. That's what that is. عصف is also used for straws, because when the wind blows, what else blows with? These tiny straws in the ground that are weak, they get plucked out and they're flying all over in the air, right? So that's what the word عصف is. But he says he made them like عصف, but he added ma'kul, chewed up, eaten. Ma'kul means that which is eaten. And asfun ma'kul was used by the Arabs, you know, these camels or these other cattle, they're going around the ground, they're chewing on stuff, and the animal picks up a large chunk to chew on in its mouth, but some of it falls out. Some of it falls out. And the remains on the floor is called asfun ma'kul. So Allah says, you want to know what they look like? They look like those leftovers that the animal has chewed on and it just slipped out of its mouth and fell. That's what they look like. If you want to know how badly they were crushed and destroyed. The idea being, when an animal uses the full strength of its jaw to chew on it and really crush it, grind it, and then it comes out in this goop on the ground, this is how Allah crushed these armies and how He made them. This is one meaning of it. Then ma'kul also means that which is, not just that which is eaten, that which is supposed to be eaten. In other words, something that is, you know, ma'kul is something that is there, and it can't help itself, you're gonna go eat it, like, you know, an animal that is about to be eaten can at least run away. But straw or hay or whatever sitting in front of an animal, that food is defenseless. Its destiny is to get destroyed. Allah compares them to a helpless piece of food that has no option but to get eaten up by its enemy. It's like they had no escape. So asfun ma'kul is used. Then the commentary by Ash-Shawkani rahimahullah, أي سلط الله عليهم تعالى عليهم طيرا, that Allah imposed upon them these birds, ترميهم بحجارة, that would stone them with sharp, precise targeting, with stones, من طين متحجر, from clay that has been turned into stones, فصاروا بسبب ذلك صرعا هالكين, and because of that they became completely crushed, chewed up, completely destroyed. And Allah describes the state of them, فِي تَمَزُّقِهِمْ وَتَنَاثُرِهِمْ كَحَالِ أَوْرَاقِ الْأَشْجَارِ. Allah uses this language to describe them, to poke fun at them. These people thought they were so powerful, and Allah compares them to the weakest thing. Not even a leaf that is connected to a tree, but a leaf that is plucked off of a tree. Completely weak. I mean, it's the symbol of greatest weakness. It doesn't even take a force to move it, winds can move it. So Allah compared the strongest army to the weakest imagery possible. So may Allah Azza wa Jalla give us a clear and a deep understanding of this book and the ability to practice upon it. May Allah Azza wa Jalla take the good things that are said and enter it into our hearts. And anything that is incorrect, may He remove it from our memories and our hearts. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Hakim wa nafa'ni wa iyyakum bil ayati wa dhikr al-Hakim. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألم تر كيف فعل ربك بأصحاب الفيل ألم يجعل كيدهم في تضليل وأرسل عليهم طيرا أبابيل ترميهم بحجارة من سجيل فجعلهم كعصف مأكول